hit hard towards second. And this gets through into right, so he turns the 0-2 count into a leadoff base hit.
Yeah, an ideal setup here with the pitcher on deck. He comes through with a solid single to start things out, and now you give your pitcher a chance to bunt you over and make a productive out.
The pitcher, Marco Estrada, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation, so let's see if that is indeed on right here. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Tries to get the bunt down here, but this is foul, and we'll see if he tries it again. To Cabrera for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw.
Yeah, you want to put this down to the right side, force that first baseman to field it, but that ball is bunted just way too hard, so that's a good decision defensively to go ahead and take the force at second.
Gene Segura standing in as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. Three our score with a man on at first and one away. Swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. Chopped foul at the plate and he stays alive, still 0-2. Ripped on the ground to first. One there.
He's out.
On to first, but not in time as he beats it out.
Well, you could have put the first base bag out in the outfield grass on this play. You're not going to double this guy up. He's too fast. Still, a pretty good job of at least getting that lead runner at second base.
Jonathan Lucroy digs in. He reached on a single and would later wind up scoring in his last at-bat. And he gets ahead with the curveball. Strike one. Runner on first. Two away. All tied at three apiece. Segura runs. A pitch out. The throw. And they'll nail him at second on a brilliant call to pitch out. And the inning is over. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We played four full. And we are all tied at three apiece. Bryant Tyner heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Bryant Tyner.
First delivery to him on the way. To first, Reynolds comes up with it. And he'll take this to the bag. Three unassisted for the first out.
The left fielder, number 52. Yoenis Cespedes.
Yoenis Cespedes will dig in again. He popped up in his first plate appearance and flew out last time around.
Well, he's putting the ball in play, but clearly getting under it too much right now. It'd be nice for him to stay through one right here.
Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Three runs, nine hits, one error in the game for the Mets thus far. And he'll try to check his swing here, but he'll have no such luck. It's strike one. On a hole now as he swings and misses at a pitch in the dirt, and it's 1-2 now. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
And even 3-2, I don't know if you want to challenge him here. Better to put him on than to give up a solo home run.
Bases are empty, one man out. That's popped up. Now towards short right field. Mazul will wait on it. And he's got it for out number two.
Well, usually when you get guys to pop up, means that you've got them off balance. And he's been able to mix things up all night long.
Robert Vinson will try it again. 0 for 2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far.
Well, guys, if you split the difference between the fly ball and the grounder he's put in play, you've got a nice line drive. So maybe we'll witness that right here.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out toward right. Braun has it in his tracks, and the inning is over. Mets go down 1-2-3. Halfway home, tied at 3. Jonathan Lucroy will start it out here for Milwaukee with Ryan Braun waiting on deck to follow.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Now here's the pitch. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Good breaking ball, but he missed inside with it. A ball and a strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Just a touch inside, perhaps. It's 2-1.
Yeah, a couple of close pitches there on the inside part of the plate. I don't think he could have done much with either one of those.
Hit hard back up the middle. And this is going to get on through into center, a leadoff hit.
Well, good job here. Stays inside the ball well, doesn't roll over, and just shoots this ball right back up the middle.
Here's Ryan Braun now. And he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one.
Oh, that is a nice pitch right there. You kind of slow it down and give him that big breaking ball to start off the at-bat. Make sure he's not a guy that's looking to ambush that first pitch fastball.
Grounded to third. This could be two. There's one. But they won't get two as he beats the relay to first.
Up next for Milwaukee, center fielder, Carlos Gomez.
Carlos Gomez will stand in now. A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game and you'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Fly ball out to right field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
And now another base runner for him to contend with now. And as we bring up his line, you can see that's an even 10 hits against him so far. And you have to wonder how much longer they're going to let him stay out there.
Settling in now, Chris Davis earned himself an RBI with a sac fly his last time at the plate. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. And it's quickly 0-2. Now this is popped meekly in the air. Playable on the infield. And he can't track it down. A base hit on a great throw from Granderson. They got him at the plate.
Yeah, and you just have to know your outfield arms out there, especially out in right field. You can see him chugging around third base. He knew it was going to be close. And a good throw here is going to nail him trying to score.
Here's Mark Reynolds. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And here's a foul tip into the catcher's glove. Moves it to 0-2 now.
That might be the best curveball we've seen out of him all night. In fact, that one buckled my knees.
The 0-2 delivery. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Brewers strand a couple. Five innings complete, all tied 3-3. Lucas Duda will dig in now as he'll lead things off for the Mets in their half of the sixth.
Number 21, Lucas Duda.
Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one. High in the air out to center field. Gomez has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Now batting, catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
Travis d'Arnaud will dig in. He doubled his last time.
And remember, he jumped all over that first pitch, so don't be surprised if he does it here again.
Now the pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Rips this one to first, but good hands over there at first, and that becomes out number two.
Worth a look at his pitches by inning so far. You can see he's up to 80 for the game right now, so he should still be in pretty good shape.
Asdrubal Cabrera will stand in. He drove in a run with a sac fly his last time. And he gripped that one a bit too tightly as it broke down and just about got him. And he misses low with it, 2-0.
No strike.
Oh, and there's a drive to deep left center. You can pretty much forget about this one. This is way out of here. So a solo shot here to left center field as they take the lead 4-3.
Wow, after the first two hitters, this inning didn't look like it was going anywhere, but you talk to a lot of hitters, and they'll tell you if they come up with two outs and nobody on, that's where they get selfish and try to swing for the fences. And that's what he did right there and launched a solo shot with two outs.
Tom Borzolani will come on now to make his 30th appearance of the year so far. David Wright will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
David Wright.
Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Davis has it in his sights, and that retires the side. The Mets do pick up a run on this solo shot. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's 4-3 New York. Rafael Montero will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the sixth.
Rafael Montero.
Archie Iwasi will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far.
And you know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first two at-bats. Seems to be seeing the ball well and putting some decent swings on it.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
Yeah, he essentially tripled up there. That means he threw the same pitch one, two, three times in a row. You don't see that very often, but it's going to work out for him as he gets the strikeout.
Into the box, Nick Mazul. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Drives it the other way to deep right. Granderson going back. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting, the pitcher.
Kirk Neuenhuis is into the on-deck circle now as he'll hit in place of the pitcher, Gorzolani.
Kirk Neuenhuis!
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
Hit in the air to right center field. This ball is carrying well. Back it goes, and it is out of here. Solo shot to right center, as that'll pull him even at four apiece.
A little vindication here against his former team. You know, I don't think he was looking at this game like it was any other game. He wanted to come in here, make a statement, and that's a pretty good one right there.
Gene Segura standing in.
Number nine.
Down the third baseline, but a foul ball here, 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Grounded to the right. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And a good effort as he's able to stick with it and get the third out of the inning. But the Brewers tie things up thanks to this solo home run. Top of the order due up to start the seventh. All even now at four apiece. Back here at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Before we start the seventh, let's pause to take a quick look at how we got here. It's our game summary through the first six innings of play. Brian Dunzing is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven.
Brian Dunzing.
Alonzo Cochran will be the first one to greet him as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Well, he's already got three hits in this game coming into this at-bat, so we'll see if he can get that fourth now against this new guy.
Drilled to first. Reynolds scoops it up, and he'll take this to the bag three unassisted for the first out.
The right fielder, number three, Curtis Granderson.
Ready now, Curtis Granderson. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
Well, nothing wrong with that. As much as it pains me to say, the pitchers have the right to work inside.
And he's behind now as he missed badly on that swing. 1-2.
Boy, what a great pitch right there. Against a power hitter, looking to pull the ball, he had no legs behind him on that swing whatsoever.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Pulled toward right center field. Braun giving chase. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
I really couldn't ask for much more out of a seventh inning guy. He's come in throwing a bunch of strikes, and he's got two quick outs to show for it here with the score still tied.
Bryant Tyner will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. Swing and a miss on a pitch in the dirt, and it's strike one.
And guys, this has been just what the doctor ordered out of the bullpen.
Yeah, they needed him to come in and give him a strong inning, and he's done exactly that.
Not the greatest at-bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now. Do you even bother with anything else here?
I sure wouldn't. As a hitter, you're thinking, look for fastball, adjust for an off-speed pitch. And so far in this at-bat, he hasn't made any adjustments.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Mazul on the grass and a leap over at first, but he comes down with his foot on the bag to record the out. Down in order go the Mets. Still all square at four apiece. Jonathan Lucroy will start it out here for Milwaukee with Ryan Braun waiting on deck to follow.
And he's already been on base three times in this ballgame, so let's see if he can do it one more time.
Here's a high pop-up. Duda is under it to tuck this one away, and it's a one-pitch out to begin the home half of the seventh.
Well, nothing better than a first-pitch pop-up to start the inning. And you'll take that every time.
Ryan Braun gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Pitch on the way. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2.
Well, he's got a different look to him in this seventh inning. Much more determined.
All knotted up, 4-4 the score here in the seventh. Way outside. 1-2. Out in front of that one. May have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Oh, that could be the defining moment of the game right there. And he's got one more guy to get through in the inning, but that was a huge out number two.
Here's Carlos Gomez. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
He's just cutting his way right through the teeth of this order. They're not even putting up much of a fight.
Frozen on strike three for the final out of the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. Score remains tied at four. Yoenis Cespedes will stand in, and it's a bullpen game now. Both starters out as we begin inning number eight.
Yeah, both starters are out, and since we're tied, both starters not going to be involved in the decision.
The pitch. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. That's 2-0 now.
Now 2-0, this is where he's the most dangerous up there. I know it's a fastball count, but I would maybe think about something else.
The 2-0 on the way. Now a ball crushed high in the air, deep to left, way back there, and that one is long gone. A solo home run here off the bat of Yoenis Cespedes, number 18 for him on the campaign, as they will take the lead here. It's now a 5-4 ball game.
Wow, he has proven to be a real nuisance in the first two games of this series. A home run in last night's ball game, and now another one here.
In now, Robert Vinson. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. At last home run, estimated to travel 431 feet. That is a long one. Bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Bases are empty here, nobody out. Three and oh now.
He knows the drill out there. You gotta make him swing the bat. Cannot be giving up walks at this stage of the game, because those could be fatal.
And no doubt about this one, it's in there, 3-1.
He can afford to be patient here because all he's looking to do is get on base and do his damage from there.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left. Davis is under it. One away.
First baseman number 21, Lucas Duda.
Lucas Duda digs in with one run in and one gone in the inning. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. In time to first, and there are two away.
Up next for the Mets, catcher Travis d'Arnaud.
Travis d'Arnaud digs in now after lining out in his last try.
Yeah, he put a good swing on it last time, so we'll see if he can make one fall here.
Here it comes. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. 0-1, here's the pitch. Grounded to third. To his left, Uwasi. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. So just the one hit in the inning, but it's a home run that pushes him out in front. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Mets 5 and the Brewers 4. Addison Reed is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Addison Reed.
Leading off the inning, Chris Davis. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, this has been a great game so far, and they're only down by one. So getting this leadoff guy on would be huge for them.
Reed's ready. Here's the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
And as we showed you a moment ago, this guy enters play with an ERA right around 2.5. So he's been a big part of this bullpen, and he gets the first guy he faces right here.
Into the box now, Mark Reynolds. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, and hopefully he got that out of his system. They really need him to come through right here.
Now the pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. One out, nobody on. Can't catch up to that pitch, and it's a ball and a strike. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. 1-1 pitch and a nice call for the change. It's 1-2. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
I'd say he's made a pretty good impression since coming on. With two batters, two strikeouts to start the inning.
Archie Uwasi stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Look out as this bat shatters on impact.
Well, you take a swing at a pitch like that, you're lucky that you only got sawed off. He's going to have to go find himself another piece of lumber.
And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Hit the other way out toward right field. There now is Granderson as he makes the catch to retire the side. Gone in order are the Brewers, and the deficit holds at 5-4. Well, there you see Brewer manager Ron Renicke out for a conference at home plate, so I would imagine we're going to see a double switch here. Phil Koch come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth.
Number 40, Phil Koch, now playing third base and batting in the ninth spot.
As Drubal Cabrera will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here. Nothing in one. Grounded back up the middle. And there's a base hit. And this could wind up as an important insurance strike here as the leadoff man's aboard to start the ninth.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see it get past second base where neither middle infielder can track it down. And it'll make its way into center field.
Juan Lagares will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 12, Juan Lagares.
Down Broadway that time. Strike one.
Yeah, and even though that's a tough one to get on top of, I think you'd say he got away with one right there. That's in too good a location when the matchup's not in your favor.
Comes set with the 0-1. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. And Reynolds won't try to pick it up as he just sweeps it away in foul territory. Here it comes on nothing and two. And he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2.
And that's a good spot for that fastball on 0-2. And that couldn't have been an easy take.
And that misses two and two.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on two and two, I don't think you fool around anymore.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
One thing we can say about this game, neither team's been afraid to swing the bat. I mean, here we are this late into the ball game, and we still haven't seen our first walk.
Now in the box, Alonzo Cochran. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
And Matt, with the double play in order, they'll obviously be looking to induce another ground ball out of him right here.
First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
That's a two-seam fastball right there. It looks to the hitter like it's going to be inside, and then it tails back to the inside corner of the plate.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Yeah, it's so hard to stay back against a guy like this. Unless you guess right, that thing's just so slow that it's almost impossible to keep from getting out on your front foot.
Liner towards second. To second for one. On to Reynolds, and they turn it a double play. Side retired. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back to Wisconsin right after this. Rolando Henderson is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Rolando Henderson.
Striding in to start the ninth, Nick Mazzulla, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, it's a close ball game, but it's starting to get late, so they need to get at least one back here in this inning.
foul back. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Boy, no messing around here in this ninth inning.
And that's a closer's mentality. They're not usually the best at setting guys up. They're going to come right at you with their best pitch, and that's usually a fastball.
And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play.
Yeah, and you can find him one spot off the top, second in the National League right now. So he's made it really tough on the opposition out of the bullpen. Manager loves giving him the ball in tight games, so we'll see if he can add to his total right here.
Dan Tackett comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. That's inside. 2-0.
And that fastball his definitely catches your attention, especially when it's on the inner half.
And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1.
Yeah, that finds a zone, but some of these pitches are getting a little too much elevation. That could come back to bite him.
Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
Well, if there is one worry about a closer throwing this hard, if anyone squares up on a fastball, this game could be tied before you know it.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Well, you get a good sense of his value to this ball club watching this. Two hitters, two strikeouts, and now they're an out away from wrapping this thing up.
Gene Segura standing in. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one.
A lot of righty pitchers will throw that two-seamer to right-handed hitters. Make sure that pitch gets inside instead of staying out over the plate. That one ran just a little too much to catch the corner.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. Here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now. Tap foul at home plate. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
And you know what? I don't care who you're playing. You know, it's never easy to go out on the road and win any game. So that was a great effort by them in every phase of the game.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. And quite a lot of offense in this one, but if we had to highlight one guy that made the difference, there he is. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, you see a couple of hits for him in the ball game. This one was tight throughout, but in the end, he really helped lead his guys to this victory.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Mets come out on top, 5-4. Good night from Milwaukee.